Look at the next problem. The letters of the word triangle are arranged at random. The probability that the word so formed starts with T and ends with R. Option A, 2 by 8 factorial. Option B, 6 by 8 factorial. Option C, 2 by 28. Option D, 1 by 56. Dear students, when the problem is involving finding number of words, we have to use permutations to calculate number of favorable cases as well as total number of cases. Here, for this problem, n of s, in this experiment, n of s means total number of words. So here, in the word triangle, 8 letters are there. All the letters are distinct. When 8 letters are taken all at a time, the number of words will be 8p8. This is 8 factorial. Here the E is the event. Out of this number of 8 factorial number of words, out of these, how many words will be starting with T and end with R? Let's see. So E be the event starting with T and end with R. Now I am calculating favorable cases. Here we have to take all letters at a time. All letters at a time means in every arrangement 8 places will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. To get the number of words starting with T and ending with R, fix the first place with T and ending place with R. Out of 8 letters, 2 are filled here. From the remaining 6 letters will be there. 6 places are here. 6 letters are required. This can be filled in 6p6 ways. This is 6 factorial. Now, probability of this event is number of favorable cases, 6 factorial divided by 8 factorial. This is 6 factorial, 8 into 7 into 6 factorial. This is 1 by 56. Option D is correct option. Next problem, using the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 digited numbers formed without repetitions, the probability that the number is divisible by 4. Options A, 1 by 5, B, 2 by 5, C, 3 by 5, D, 4 by 5. Dear students, observe here, in the given digits, there is no zero. When zero is given, you should be careful that whatever the numbers you are forming, there first place should not occupy with that zero digit. So here all are significant digits, there is no zero here. So for this problem, n of s, total number of given the digits are 5, all are significant digits. With this, 4 digited numbers can be formed in 5p4 ways. This is n of s. Here the event e is, out of these 5p4 numbers, how many such numbers will be there which are divisible by 4? So here the number divisible by 4. For this, favorable cases n of e. So here the number, 4 digited number divisible by 4. four-digited number divisible by 4. So what is divisibility condition for a number? Any digited number is divisible by 4 whenever the digits, with the digits in units place and tens place, that digits formed number, that number is a multiple of 4. So here I am going to find such how many pairs are there which are multiples of 4 with the given digits. They are 1, 2 means 12 multiple of 4. Again, 3, 2 multiple of 4. Again, 5, 2 multiple of 4. One more, 2, 4. Means here the digit should be 1, 2. Means this pair should be fixed here. Or 3, 2, 5, 2, 2, 4. All these are possible pairs to arrange here. Means 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 pairs are there. Out of these 4 pairs, one pair is required. This can be done in from 4 pairs arranging one pair. Out of 5 digits, 2 digits will be here. Remaining 3 digits, remaining 2 places from 3 digits arranging 2 digits. This is 3P2. First operation, second operation, both are happening at a time. Therefore, by multiplication principle, n of e is 4p1 into 3p2. Probability of success is 3p2 into 4p1 divided by 5p4. So this is 1/5. Option A is correct option. Look at the next problem. 2 squares are chosen at random on a chessboard. The probability that they have a side in common. Options 1/9, option B 2/7, option C 1/18, option D 1/3. Dear students, here in a chessboard, total number of squares, it will have 8 rows, 8 columns. In 8 rows, 8 columns, the total number of squares are 64. So from 64 squares, selecting totally 2 squares, 64C 2 ways. This is N of S. Now, E is the event. The event E is selected 2 squares, sides are common. How many such selections can be made? Look here, to calculate N of E. In a chessboard, there are 8 columns, 8 rows. Here the selection is, whatever the 2 squares you are selecting, their sides should be common. How many such selections can be made? Look here. The possibilities, I am calculating for the first row, one row. For a first row, we can select these 2 squares. One side is common. This is one possibility. Second possibility, third possibility, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Means for each row, 7 possibilities. For 8 rows, for each row, 7 possibilities. For 8 rows into 8. This is row wise. If you take column wise, that is almost double of this. So I will take 2 into 7 into 8. This is per row. This is for 8 rows. This is in row wise. This is column wise. For column wise into 2. So N of E is product of 2, 7, 8. Now, probability of E is 2 into 7 into 8 divided by N of S is 64C2. This is 1/8. 18, the option C is correct. The next problem, the letters of the word kutir are arranged in all possible ways. The probability that no two vowels come together. The options A 1/5, B 2/5, C 3/4, D 1/4. Here, the students, once again I would like to remind you, the word kutir involving three vowels, three consonants. Here the condition is, in every arrangement, two vowels always come together. This is the event. For this experiment, I am finding n of s, total number of outcomes. So here problem involving arrangement of letters means arrangement of words. Therefore, using permutations, taken all at a time, letters of the word kutir, six letters are there. Out of six letters, six factorial. Out of six, two are alike, two factorial. This is n of s. Now, E is the event, arrangement of letters of the word kutir, no two vowels come together. No two vowels come together. For this, to get favorable cases, n of e. To get no two vowels come together means between two vowels, at least one consonant must be there. Therefore, first I will arrange all three consonants. Those consonants are K, T, R. So, three consonants taken all at a time, this can be arranged in three factorial ways, 3p3. After arrangement, we can find 1, 2, 3, 4 gaps. In these four gaps, we can arrange three vowels. They are U, E, E. Three vowels, arrangement of three vowels into four places, 4p3, out of two are alike, therefore by 2 factorial. So this is first operation, second operation, by multiplication principle, total number of operations. N of E is 3 factorial into 4p3 by 2 factorial. Now, probability of success. This is 3 factorial into 4p3 by 2 factorial, whole divided by N of S, 6 factorial by 2 factorial. On simplification, you will get 1/5. So, A is correct option. Look at the next problem. Two cards are drawn from a pack. The probability that at least one of the two is heart. Options A 1-39C2/52C2. Option B 13C1×39C1/52C2. Option C 26C1×26C1/52C2. Option D 39C2×52C2. Dear students, here two cards are drawing in total from a pack of 52 cards. For this problem, it's very simple that N of S is from 52 cards, selecting total two cards. Always to calculate NFS, consider total number of cards available, total number of cards to select without any restrictions. 52 cards are available, selecting total two cards, that is 52C2. Now I am writing the event. E is the event of selected two cards. In the selected two cards, at least one means greater than or equal to one heart. At least one is heart. Here, to this event, at least one means that can be either one heart or two hearts. Means you have to select maximum two cards. Out of these two cards, at least one heart means either one is heart or two is heart. Dear students, sometimes finding success probability for that event, finding favorable cases might be a bit difficulty. In such cases, we will calculate failure probability. Then with that, we will calculate success probability. Here, I will write the failure for this event E. Here E is the event at least one heart out of two cards. So here E bar is at least one. To this event, I am writing the failure. We have to select two cards. From these two cards, for this event, the failure is less than one heart. Less than one heart. This means out of two cards, less than one heart means zero heart. That means selected two cards which are not hearts. Therefore, for this favorable cases for this event, failure event, selected both the cards should not be hearts. Means those can be selected from out of 52 cards. If you remove 13 hearts, then remaining 39 cards will be there. These 39 cards which are not hearts, from these 39 cards, you can select two cards which are not hearts. Now I am going to calculate probability of success for this event is 1 minus probability of, this is 1 minus probability of failure. Failure favorable cases 39C2 by total number of cases 52C2. This is probability of success is 1 minus 39C2 by 52C2. Therefore, first option is correct. Look at the next problem. From first 20 natural numbers, if two numbers are selected at random, then the probability of selecting them which are not consecutive. Dear students, here given first 20 natural numbers, all of them are consecutive. Here I am calculating what is N of S? N of S is 20 natural numbers are given. From 20 natural numbers, selecting two numbers that can be done in 20C2 ways. This is very simple to find. Here, I am writing the event. Event is selected two numbers. Selected two numbers are not consecutive. Consecutive means, sometimes finding success probability or favorable cases for the success event is not possible. In that case, we'll calculate failure cases. With that, we can calculate success probability. Here, I am writing failure for this event means selected two numbers which are consecutive. Means how many such cases will be there? Selected two numbers will be consecutive. For this, look here. We have 20 natural numbers means 1, 2, 3, 4, so on to 18, 19, 20. Out of all this, how many number of ways of selecting each time two numbers which are consecutive? Look here, This is one way, two way, three ways, four ways, so on to 18 ways, 19 ways. Means number of favorable cases for this failure is 19 ways we can selected two numbers are consecutive. So now I am calculating probability of success. This is 1 minus probability of failure. This is 1 minus failure favorable cases 19 divided by total number of cases 20 C2. This is, after simplification, you will get 9/10, which is option A. ಪ್ರಿಯ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳೇ, ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಪ್ರಾಬಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ನಿಂದ ಕೆಲವು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳನ್ನು ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಐ ವಿಶ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ CET ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್. ಇಂತೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ರಾಜು, ಲೆಕ್ಚರರ್ ಇನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್, KLEPU ಕಾಲೇಜ್. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ.